Good morning, students of class 10. In the previous online class, we had studied about definition of methods, method prototype, method signature, defining methods, need of methods, and type of variables. Now, we will switch over to the new topics. They are methods with parameters, way of passing parameters, actual and formal parameters, then pure and impure functions, call by value and call by reference, and method overloading. We need to know that methods can be passed, methods can be without parameters also and with parameters also. Let's discuss first methods without parameters. With an example, so have void set b c plus b system.out.println then value of c plus c, right? In this method, I have not defined any parameter. And method name is set b and I have not defined any parameter in this method. Let's see an example with parameters. Int add int a int b int c c equal to a plus b return C. Now see, in the first method, I have not defined any parameter, but still I am able to get the output because here C plus, it means that C equal to C plus B, right? And the system.out.println, we are able to get the output of value of C. In the second example, I had given you the example with parameters. Add is a method and the variables I had defined here, int a and int b. And in the main program, I said that the value of c is equal to a plus b. And in the return, the value of c is printed. Let's discuss your actual parameters and formal parameters. Actual parameters are those parameters that appears in the method call. In the other words, the value which are passed to the method during its call from the caller are the arguments known as actual parameters. Let's see the example here. In this given program, public add int x and y, this is your formal parameters, and see here, after defining your main method, when we are calling the value of a and b and giving the value to a and b, this is called your actual parameter. In the definition, we had learned that the actual parameters are those parameters that appears in the method call. When we are calling the method, see, when we are calling the method, that time only that actual parameters appears. Now let's see your formal parameters. Formal parameters are those parameters that appears in the method definition. When we are defining a method, that time your formal parameters appear. For example, int add, int a and int b. When we are add is your method, so when defining your method, we introduce your parameters, that is called your formal parameters. This is an example of your formal parameter, and that is the example of your actual parameter. Let's discuss your way of passing parameters. Child, there are two ways of passing parameters when we are defining your functions. They are call by value and call by reference. By using two ways only, your parameters can be passed while having the methods. First is a call by value. Let's see actual parameters and formal parameters, I guess, is clear to you. Now, if A and B is our actual parameters, and in a value of A is 10 and the value of B is 5, what in the call by value method happen, or what is in the call by value, the value of actual parameters are passed to the value to the formal parameter. See, the value of A is passed to the value of X and the value of B is passed to the value of Y. Let's go through the points also. The value of actual parameter is passed to the value of formal parameter. The value of A is passed to X and the value of B is passed to Y. So simply, the actual parameter value is passed to the value to the formal parameters. Next, we see that this is the simplest method of passing the parameters, because simply we are passing the value from actual parameter to formal parameters. The operation perform and formal parameter do not change the value of actual parameter. Now see, when we are passing the value from actual parameter to formal parameter, when we pass the value, and if we want to modify this value from 10 to 15 or 5 to 10, then the value of actual parameter will not change. It will not, the working of formal parameter is not going to affect the working of actual parameter. Same value will be resist on the both sides. Let's see with the help of example. In this programming, int A and int B is your formal parameter. And X and Y is your actual parameter. In a call by value, actual parameter simply passes the value to the formal parameter. If the value of X is 10 and the value of Y is 5, automatically the value of A is 10 and the value of B is 5. Now see the operation here. A plus 10, it means that 10 plus 10, because the value of A is, A goes to X, so the value of that it will indicate 10 plus 10. And here the value of Y was 5. That's why B multiply by 2 equal to 5 multiply by 2. This is an example of your call by value. Let's discuss your call by reference. In call by reference, the value from actual parameter are passed to the formal parameters, but if there is a change in a formal parameters, then the value will automatically get updated to the actual parameter. Let's see. Normally, whenever we are working with the computer, simply whatever the input we give, we get the output according to the depending on the input only. But in the call by reference, you whatever the input you will give, it's not necessary that similar output or similar type of output you will get. Now let's discuss your call by reference. In call by reference, another name of call by reference is a call by location. Now first see, in an actual parameter, whenever we pass the value from actual parameter to the formal parameter in a call by value, we are not supposed to make the changes in the formal parameters. Whatever the value of actual parameter is there, the same value you will have the formal parameters. But if in the actual parameter the value is 10 and if we had updated or modified the value from 10 to 15, automatically the value of actual parameter is changed. Let's see the points. This method is called call by address or call by reference, because simply we are addressing the values of actual parameter, the location of actual parameters and the formal parameters. The value of actual parameter can be changed. The value of actual parameter can be changed whenever you are going to, as I told you, when you will change the value of formal parameter, automatically the value of actual parameter will be changed. There is indirect access using pointer. Now there is no direct access. In call by value there was a direct access, but in a call by reference there is an indirect access, because we are considering their locations only. So there is indirect access using pointers. With the help of these pointers, First of all, the value of the formal perimeter will be modified, then the value is updated. And how we are able to update? With the help of these pointers. In call by reference, we directly modify the actual perimeter value by the reference of an object. Let's see the example. Here, these are your actual perimeters, and formal perimeter's value is not given here. So actual perimeter is simply pass the value to the formal perimeters. When we are calling the objects and we had changed the value, automatically the value of a formal perimeter is also changed. Let's discuss your call difference between call by value and call by reference. The actual perimeters are the copy to the formal perimeters. In the call by value, we are simply passing the value of actual perimeter to the formal perimeter. And in call by reference, the actual perimeter are not copied to the formal perimeters. They are just referred by the name. Like I had given you the example of A and B, X and Y. So they get referred through the name. Memory is allocated separately for actual and formal perimeters in call by value. And in call by reference, because we are referring through the name only, so the memory is not allocated separately for actual and formal perimeters. Next point we have, any change made to the formal perimeter will not affect or change the actual perimeter. Like we have discussed, if you will change the value of formal perimeters and call by value, the value of actual perimeter remain same only. And in call by reference, any change made to the formal perimeter will automatically change the value to the actual perimeter with the help of pointer. Last point we have, the actual perimeter can be variable, constant or expression. Because we are using the values, so it can be variable, it can be constant, it can be expression. And in call by reference, the actual perimeter can be reference type of variable only.